So you're looking for a new driver, huh? I got one question for you. Why? Why do you need another driver? Is it because you're not getting along with your driver? Or is it because you think your driver is ugly? Or is it because there's a new driver on the block? If you answered yes to any of these, you are the red flag. Yes, you heard me right. You're the toxic one. Like Vin Diesel once said, it doesn't matter what's under the hood. The only thing that matters is who's behind the wheel. In other words, the driver was never a problem. It was you. Don't get me wrong, anything new is very exciting. But just because it's new doesn't mean it's always better. Seeing and buying a new driver is exhilarating. You want to practice, you think you can hit it farther, it's shiny, it's new. But if your sole reason to upgrade your driver is to get more distance, you are the problem. Every year it's the same agenda with the new drivers. Distance this, distance that. New innovative braking technology, but guess what? I'm sick and tired of hearing the same thing year after year. Let me back up my claim with the numbers. Take a look at this video. This is a video released 6 years ago. It's by Rick Shields. We all know who Rick Shields is, the OG of golf YouTube. So he did a test, basically a driver from the past 5 years. And as you can see from the numbers, the newest model did not produce the furthest distance. Every year they're claiming new distance, but clearly it's not. There's probably some human errors, some different factors. Only the best way to control this variable is having a robot testing, but I trust Rick Shields enough. And going off these numbers alone, something suspicious. Let me go one more. Let's pick on Callaway. So this video here is also by Rick Shields. He tested the new Callaway paradigm against a 30-year-old Callaway driver. As you can see, the numbers, they look pretty good. They're 20 yards difference, but mind you, these are 30 years of R&D, innovative technology, 30 years of research, and they still couldn't improve 1 yard every year. But here's the biggest factor. Look at the head difference. The paradigm, 460cc. Look how much smaller the other driver is. With that variable alone, of how much the head difference is, that explains why the new driver produces a further distance. My hypothesis, if the old driver was the same head size as the new driver, I'm guessing and I'm predicting the distance would be very close. New drivers are definitely appealing and makes golf a lot more exciting. So if you're on the market for new drivers, go for it. I'm not saying not to. Do whatever you want to do. But all I want to point out is, don't get fooled every year. If you're not playing the newest technology, you're at a disadvantage. Don't get me wrong, the forgiveness of new drivers is definitely noticeable between old drivers. But that's the biggest difference between the two. The main thing I recommend is finding a driver that's best fitted for you. As long as a driver fits for you, fits for your specs, it's all that matters. You're not at a disadvantage for players that have the newest technology. So if you're looking for a new driver, go for it. Do whatever you want to do, just don't get fooled. Don't be the toxic one. That's all I have for you today. It's your boy, I am Choiboi. Peace.